Bilingualism. Today we are going to begin a new course based on several modules on bilingualism. Now the topic of bilingualism is directly related to second language acquisition because it means adding on a new language to the language you already have. In addition, bilingualism is also related to the multilingual context to which you belong. In Pakistan, where more than almost everybody has more than one language that he or she can speak. So in this specific module, what are we going to cover? We are going to look at different definitions of bilingualism, as in other spaces, as is true of other contexts. Bilingualism has been defined separately by different researchers, policymakers, and these definitions are very important, and we will see why that is the case. We will also try to understand what are the issues related to the definitions that have been put across to explain bilingualism. And why is it so important to be able to define bilingualism itself? We will also try to understand language behavior. That is, when do we use two languages? Do we use one language at a specific time? Or do we use different varieties of the same language if it is a monolingual context? And why that is the case? We will also look at language behavior from functionalist approach. Now, having said that, please remember that there are several approaches to understanding, to understand bilingualism. However, to keep it narrowed down, to give some sort of coherence to what we are to what we will discuss, we have chosen a functionalist approach, which personally I agree with, and we will also look at the interlink between function and language itself. What comes first? Is function important, or and is the function that is what gives rise to language, or is it the other way around? We will discuss that also. And then we will also look at the similarities across languages. That is, what is it that is similar in language behavior across different contexts? Now, let me remind you, we are not studying linguistics. So we are not saying what is similar across language structures. We are looking at what is similar across the use of language, across the languages that are being used all over the world. So we will try to come across some basic concepts or basic assumptions that are being made. We will also like to look at what is the difference in form of different languages, and how is this form of language affected by culture. Now, in other words, this would mean how is language related to culture, and how is culture reflected in language? Again, in terms of bilingualism, it is a major question. We will finally also look at language and literacy and the issue of bilingualism. It has been a major issue in Pakistan regarding which languages should be used for literacy, or in schools. Should we use the home languages in schools? Should we use both languages in schools and colleges or universities? So all over the world, wherever you have multilingual context, which is, I would say now with so much immigration going on, so much change going on around the world, even countries that claim to be somehow monolingual, they are also facing this question of multilingualism, the diversity of languages in their classes, and the question of how to provide an education which is meaningful to the students and which enables them to participate in the country they are living. So this whole question of bilingualism and multilingualism, we will briefly touch upon and then discuss it later in the course.